In the last video, we divided our dragon head into multiple pieces and created some UVs for the neck. In this tutorial, we'll finish off the rest of the head. Let's start with the crest. Apply the existing checker pattern material to the crest by right-clicking it and selecting Assign Existing Material. Like the neck, we're going to start with a planar mapping here. However, unlike the neck, the crest is wider than it is tall, so it would be better if we projected the UVs from the top. Go to the Planar Mapping Options menu and change to a projection from the Y-axis. At a first glance, this actually looks pretty good. The squares are all evenly aligned. However, turning on the Shade UV display in the UV Texture Editor shows us most of the faces highlighted in purple, meaning the UVs are overlapping. Unlike the neck, which was roughly cylindrical, the crest isn't a play on a primitive shape. The best way to unfold this would be such that we have the top and bottom crescents side by side. Let's start cutting UV edges to make this possible. Start with the inner ring. Don't forget the edge connecting to the skull on either side. Select Polygons Cut UV Edges from the UV Texture Editor. Now select the edges along the outer rim of the crest and cut them. Select a central point on the back of the crest and unfold the UVs using it as a pin. The unfolded UV mesh isn't exactly what we were expecting, is it? The top and bottom crest didn't fan out and are still overlapping. Let's undo that and try to figure out where we went wrong. It would be much easier to figure out our mistake if we could see where our cut UV edges were. Select Display, Polygons, Texture Border Edges to do just that. Maya bolds the UV texture borders in both the viewport and UV texture editor. If you find the border edges hard to see, you can adjust their width in the custom polygons display options. Looking at our newly bolded edges, the problem becomes apparent. We cut these edges such that they will become two completely separate texture meshes. However, if we want to unfold this, they need to join up somewhere. Select the two edges at the back tip of the crest. Now sew these back together using the Sew UV Edges command in the UV Texture Editor. Now once again, select a central point to pin and try unfolding again. This time, we'll also constrain the unfold to vertical, since we know the direction we want to unfold in. Now the crest unfolds nicely into two crescents. We're not quite done though. While the checker pattern is pretty uniform, it distorts a lot around where the bulbs attach to the head. We can smooth this out using the Smooth UV tool. Select the UVs in the bulb area and then click and drag the Unfold option to the right. Notice that as you unfold the localized area, the texture smooths out in the viewport. Select all the UVs and move them to the side. This will make our UV plane easier to lay out later. We can mostly follow the same steps for the skull. Project another planar mapping along Y and cut the edges along the line of symmetry inside the jaw. Since the head is so much longer than the crest or neck, we'll want to pin all the UVs on the top plate this time. Also make sure to set the unfold constraint to none, so the mesh unfolds in every direction. That's pretty good. You can see some small distortions in the mesh. There's a small spike here, which you can fix with the Smooth UV Tools Relax function. There is also a little bit of overlap in these two corners. Unfortunately, the space is too tight to use the Smooth tool. You will have to tweak the UVs yourself with the Move tool. Using what you've learned, try to lay out the rest of the pieces yourself. If you get stumped, we've provided a fully laid out version of this tutorial file. The tongue, the throat, and the teeth should have been fairly straightforward, but the lower jaw, being the most irregular shape of this entire model, may have posed a bit of a challenge. In this instance, you'll notice that we've made some UV edge cuts and projected our UV mapping from the front. But if we unfold this, notice that the rear jaw highlighted here has distorted heavily. The unfold command unfolds around the pinned UV points. However, the UVs on the rear jaw are too far from the pinned points to unfold evenly like those closer to them. To fix this, we'll need a few more points to unfold around. Undo the unfold and find these two points on the outer edge of each jaw. We can't simply pin the points here, otherwise we're going to get a lot of overlapping UVs. Instead, in the UV texture editor, move these two UVs down from the upper jaw. This will give the mesh some room to unfold. Now shift select the UVs on the front of the jaw and run the unfold command again. This time the outer jaw unfolds more evenly around the two pinned points. In general, you can drag UV points around and pin them like this to better control how your mesh unfolds. Now that you have all these separate pieces unfolded correctly, it's time for us to recombine them back into a single head. Select all the pieces of the head, minus the corneas. Just like the neck in part 1 of this tutorial, we'll have to select the UVs for each of these objects individually, scale them, and lay them out so that they aren't overlapping. Try to make the larger and more prominently visible areas of the mesh larger in the UV texture editor as well, to allow yourself room to paint the proper details. Now that all our objects are laid out evenly, we can recombine the components that we'd originally separated. Select the neck, crest, skull, lower jaw, tongue, and throat, and then select the combine command. Now select all the vertices and select Edit Mesh, Merge. In the Merge options, set the threshold to 0.001. We want the threshold small enough so that all the overlapping vertices from the different objects will merge, but not the vertices that are simply close together. Now delete your history and rename the newly recombined mesh. We'll leave the teeth and eyes as their own meshes for animation purposes, but you can shift select them to keep them on the same UV space. Now, like part 1 of this tutorial, you can output a UV snapshot to paint in your 2D authoring software. After creating a texture in our 2D authoring software, we need to apply it to our model. Select everything except the corneas and create a new blend texture called Dragon Matte. In the attribute editor, assign the dragontexture.tiff file to the color attribute of your new material. As a bonus, we've also included a normal map for the dragon skin as well. Load the dragon normal file in the bump mapping attribute. Now turn on high-quality rendering to see it. If you find the skin too shiny, you can adjust the specular color to matte it. Here is our finished 3D head in the viewport, and the corresponding textures we made using the snapshot in the UV texture editor. Notice all the detail we get using the exact same low-res mesh as before. This will give us the best of both worlds when it comes to detail and performance.